Back on gaming. Yeah. Back on gaming. I'm going to say this now. It's been about, what, 2 weeks since I've done a gaming video, since I was away. I went to MomoCon and stuff like that. And I know a number of people will keep asking me to talk about MomoCon. But as you can see in the header, we have a lot of serious issues to talk about this week. So the stuff for MomoCon, I'm going to have to push that and put that on the back burner for next week. Because there's some things I need to talk about with MomoCon. And also things I want to show you as well. Certain games, you know, like I said, there's pictures I took as well. And I want to talk about these type of games that I felt need to be, you know, need to be promoted. However, I need to talk about the serious issues this week. It's been 2 weeks, all right? And in 2 weeks, as y'all know, every time I leave, something bad happens. You know this, all right? However, I have to say this. It's been 2 weeks, and you're going to tell me in the community that nobody wants to be an adult, and nobody wants to stand up and speak on these issues and say, hey, look, this is fucking wrong. This needs to be, you know, needs to be corrected. Or things that you see are coming down the line and say, okay, we need to stop this shit before it happens. But no, you don't want to do that either. You want to sit back and you want to fucking ignore it. You want to sit back and you want to laugh at it. You want to sit here and say it's not that big of a deal. It's always the point, and these are from adults. These are from kids. These are from fucking adults. Okay? So it's always to the point where you always say, you love this community. You pride yourself off this community. But when serious shit gets ready to go down, once again, you are nowhere around. You always ignore your shit. You always put your head in the fucking sand. You always put your fingers in your fucking ears. La, la, la. That's what the fuck you do. Every time. But I guarantee you, if I talk about said game that you love so much and say it's trash, here the fuck you come. I just don't know anymore. I just feel as though when you see these type of serious issues, it is amazing to see. Like I said, it's not just the issues at hand that are bothersome, but it's the responses from these people. Yeah, that the so-called say they love the community. That makes it worse. So let's get started with the SJW shit. The hypocrisy shit. I want to get this out the way first because of how the community is taking a hit. And you have to understand, the community has done a lot this week to fuck themselves over, alright? Companies have, well, some of them have. I mean, yeah, hello Ninja Theory, we see what you've done. We'll talk about that later, okay? But, like I said, mostly the community. And if you get mad, then you get fucking mad. But these are serious issues that need to be addressed. And if you get mad over it, well, fucking, oh well. You don't deserve to be here then, as far as I'm concerned. I just don't understand. Look, there's a time and place where you say, hey, I just want to play video games and have fun. I understand that. But when you have certain issues in the community that need to be addressed, then you fucking address them. You address them, you get it over with, and then you go back to your fun. You know what I mean? That's what you do. We're talking about the safety of people here today. At least I'm sure you can see it in the fucking header. Alright? The safety of people today. However, like I said, let's start these SJWs. I want to start with one piece of shit, Jim Sterling. That's right. Now, we know for the previous year or so, the way he has acted, even before that even, the way he has acted has been absolutely ridiculous. Him, Movie Bob, a bunch of them. You know, the usual suspects. But you can't sit here and say you're going to be champion of justice and social justice and that women, you know, are being portrayed as sex objects in video games. Don't give a shit about real women in real life, because I don't see people at rallies or anything like that to help women, especially in third world countries where they're being abused and all this other shit. Never talk about that, right? No, not at all. But women in video games, it's a major problem the way they're dressed and sexualized and everything. And then you turn around and you make a petition, you push the petition for people who want to see Mario Dick. So that's where we're at now, huh? So let me get it straight, alright? Women are being portrayed as sex objects. Oh my god, it's hot right here, oh my god! Hey yo, we want to see Mario Dick! I've never seen so many people hungry for dick, ever. Ever. It's crazy. Put a petition for that, and then a petition for the petition, and the petition falls through, because Nintendo's like, get the fuck out of here with that shit. You've got to be kidding me. This is what we waste our time on now. These champions of justice! This is what you do. The hypocrisy is so strong. It's so thick. You could cut it with a knife at this point. It's ridiculous. But that's not all. No. David Jaffe. That's right. We'll talk about one David Jaffe. Because remember, not too long ago, David Jaffe had made some comments. Remember those kids on Twitter, you know, because they're prom. They had, you know, a theme, a superhero theme, you know, the boys and girls. And David Jaffe came out and said, that was sexist. And he's trying to be another social justice warrior. He's trying to get back in her good graces. The creator of God of War, mind you. Alright, is trying to get in the SJW's good graces when it comes to being either sex positive or sex negative, depending on who you listen to. Okay? Yeah. So, apparently, David Jaffe wants to clear the air, and he goes on TV about this shit. That's right, goes on TV. Have you noticed that most of these people, after they get this backlash from saying absolutely stupid things on Twitter, they go and take the TV? Brianna Wu, Nia Sarkeesian, all these people, they go and take the TV every time. David Jaffe is just another person who is following in their footsteps. But I want you to listen to what David Jaffe has to say about his comments about those kids being sexist. You know, that superhero theme was so sexist.
I found the photo hit me at some kind of level that felt just uncomfortable, right? Not that there's anything wrong with being uncomfortable, but it was just like, there's something weird about this. My knee-jerk was to go, A, to post a really stupid, childish way of expressing myself, which is sort of, I guess, what Twitter's for, which is horrible, and I'm 45 and I shouldn't be doing that, but I don't care.
Yeah, we're going to stop right there. And I say we're going to stop right there because I like how Jaffe tries to blow by that very quickly. You know, he talks about how he wanted to post, you know, he posted something very childish to express himself, but that's what Twitter is for, and he's 45 and all. Yeah, he just tried to go by that as fast as possible. No, we're going to stop you right there, bro. All right, let's get something straight here. You already admit that you've already done wrong, and that it was childish of you to do, and that you're 45 years old. But here's the thing. Given your history, all right, because you've done this in real life. That's right, mind you, you're 45 years old. You've done this in real life as well. So it's not just a Twitter thing. It's a you thing. Because, mind you, when you were at conventions, what did you do? You try and bully cosplayers, did you not? Out-of-shape cosplayers who were trying to dress as their favorite superhero or whatever, and you admit it you did that, and you admit it you were wrong. So this is something that you've done before. You have a track record of doing stupid shit, immature shit, childish shit. Now, for the second part, for you to say, but that's what Twitter is for, ha, no. I don't know how many times I have to say this. Just because you're online, it doesn't give you a free pass to act like a fucking idiot. Do you think that everybody uses Twitter simply to talk and post childish shit? Is that what you think? Because if so, then you don't know enough people. Obviously, you're not, you know what, you shouldn't even be on there, as far as I'm concerned, if you think that's what Twitter is for. Everybody can use the internet for a said reason, if they wanted to. That's not an excuse or a justification for you to act like a dick, alright? That's just that simple, alright? Take some responsibility. But you're going to sit here and try to push that as fast as possible. Well, that's what it's for, everyone does it, so I did it. That's what you just did, okay? Let's move on from there, shall we?
I did it, right? But the bigger thing was, it really wasn't sexist, but it felt correct to call it sexist. And it wasn't until I did this post that I got such an outcry.
So you admit it wasn't sexist, all right? Like everyone else said, wasn't sexist. But you felt correctly to call it sexist. That doesn't even make sense. You are contradicting yourself. You look like a hypocrite. On top of it, people, you have to understand, this man is exposing himself right now. That's what he's doing, all right? No one told you to go on TV and act this way. No, you did that yourself, okay? You're exposing yourself. And I have to say, look at this from a human being standpoint. I don't care about your past achievements of what you've made. As a human being, for you to say something like this, I have to ask, who the fuck would want to work with you after that? Who would? Like I said, I don't care about your past achievements. That shit don't mean nothing. God of War don't mean shit, all right? We're talking about from a reality standpoint. Who the fuck would want to be around you? At this point, David Jaffe, you have to, and I would suggest, don't do any more TV interviews. Don't. You fucked yourself up all there. Just don't do it anymore, okay? I would suggest you deactivate your Twitter, because as a 45-year-old man, you actually tried to play the, well, everyone else does it, so I did it too. Obviously, you don't know how to be responsible to use your Twitter, so, or the internet in general, so you should deactivate your Twitter and stay off the internet as far as I'm concerned. That's another thing, okay? As a 45-year-old man. I would say thoroughly, you need to take a long look in the mirror and ask yourself, do I need help? Seriously. No bullshit. No, it's not to disrespect you or to cut you down. No, seriously. Do you need help? Because when you say something like that, it tells me that you don't have any real world experience, any real life experience. I mean, we're talking about a guy, and for those who don't know, all right, a couple years ago, who had to lean, believe it or not, leaned on Hip Hop Gamer because he thought that was going to be the authentic black experience because he didn't know enough minorities. Yeah. I would suggest, Jaffe, that you go outside and start talking to people. Learn about people from other cultures and other backgrounds of life. to understand how other people feel and have more of a larger experience, a vast experience, before you decide to get online and say, that's sexist, even though you're admitting it's not sexist. It seems like you have a lot of problems, underlying problems, you know. And I'm not, and when I say this, I mean as a human being, because we're not going to get to this point where you said something outrageous, everyone got outraged, and then we're just waiting for the next bit of news to come along so that it can just, you just put, you know, push it under the rug and it just goes away and everyone forgets about it. And then everyone says, hey, remember that time? No, we're not going there. Clearly, you have some problems that need to be straightened out. So as far as I'm concerned, get some fucking help. And it seems like you're not trying to help yourself, because since this interview, you're still online talking to people. Still, like, okay, you said what you had to say and that's it. You're not trying to help yourself. You're not trying to correct the situation. Because getting on TV, if you thought that was correcting the situation, that's not the way to go about it. It's amazing how we keep seeing this time and time again with people. Every time they get some type of backlash from the internet, here they go to run on TV. I don't understand. But let's move on. That's right. More SJW talk. Because for those who don't know, that's right. The get good mentality has been apparently thrown into the trash by SJWs, and you know, because of what happened with Polygon with Doom, we're going to talk about this, alright? Because for those who don't know, BuzzFeed News. How Manny Mercy from Overwatch, right, made me want to go to medical school. But I want you to see the rest of this. I'm going to put the picture up for you so you can see the little, the bottom part of it, of what they talk about, the get good mentality. Now, for those who can't read that, it says, they told me to get good, so I set my sights on Harvard Medical School. Number one, let's get into this, all right? Manning a medic in a game, I guess it could be inspiring to go and do something in the medical field, all right? But it clearly isn't about playing as Mercy in Overwatch to make you go to medical school, all right? Don't tell me just you play this, I have an epiphany, I want to go to medical school. It doesn't work that way. Anybody who goes to school, you know you have to have the right grades, you have to have the right grade point average. Your SATs better be good, all right, to enroll in some type of medical school. Unless you're going to start from, like, I won't say from the bottom, as in I'm going to go to community college and work my way up, you know, when I get my credits up, to go to other colleges to transfer. That's different. Don't tell me just out of nowhere you had this epiphany because you're remaining as Mercy. Mind you, other video games have done this in the past where you can play as medic. I remember Resistance 2, you could play as a medic. There's many a games you can play as a medic. You're going to tell me it took Mercy from Overwatch to make you feel as though you need to go to Harvard? No, clearly it is a shot at the good get good mentality. So let's talk about the get good mentality. As of late, we have seen a number of places, because of what happened with the Doom video and Polygon, that all these, you know, these sites all of a sudden are coming out and saying that the get-good mentality is very toxic. So, let's look at some of the sites saying it already. I do love that second article, because it says, you know, they don't take games. This is why people don't take games seriously, because of the get-good mentality. I'm thinking to myself, they're games. You're not supposed to take them seriously. You're not supposed to. But let's venture down this road, okay, with these people. Because they want to say that the get good mentality for telling people to get better is toxic. I find that funny, because the get good mentality has always been about telling people to never give up. No matter how hard the obstacle is, don't give up. Get good. Because if you don't get good and you're going through these games and you think that all of a sudden that you shouldn't raise your skill level, then you won't beat said game. Get good. Granted, it's lightly teasing. Get good, mate. You know what I mean? It's lightly teasing, but it's nothing serious for you to say, oh my god, these people are harassing us, and it's toxic, and these people are so mean-spirited. I never thought that telling people to get better and to never give up in said game, or never give up in life, because I put it like this. If you're giving up on said game so easily and trying to blame everyone across the map, across the board on this one, across the platform, whatever you want to call it, all right, that if we say get good, it's looked as a negative. I can only imagine what happens when, in real life, like when you go through school. If your teacher tells you you're failing and you need to get better, do you just say, oh, it's toxic, I can't believe you said that to me? It's like, is that what you, like, when you go to work, alright, and your boss tells you you're not doing a good job, you need to get better at your job to keep your job, are you going to turn to your boss and say, oh, what you're saying is toxic, I can't believe you're saying that? Like, Do you not think before you speak? It's this simple. To get good mentality is a way of life. Not just competition, but you should know by now, in this world, you're very competitive. Every day you're competing to survive, right? And they're talking about people who have jobs, okay? Not these bloggers who hope if they say something for clickbait and then you click on it, they can get money and please help me because victim bucks. Nah, I'm not trying to hear that shit, all right? We're talking about people who have jobs. You have to understand that if you do not do your job, you're going to lose your job, which means you can't support yourself, you can't support your family, you have to be good at what you do. Okay? So for these people to sit here and say, well, this mentality is absolutely wrong in gaming, you're actually saying this mentality is absolutely wrong in life. And it's sad, because it shows me that you've never had any type of obstacle put in your way, you've never had to overcome any type of feat, you're literally sitting at home saying that you want to be this special, delicate snowflake, and that if I tell you that if you suck at a game, to get better, to not give up, that you're going to say, I'm the bad guy. The dose of reality really hurts you people, doesn't it? And for this person to say, well, they told me to get good, so I'm going to medical school, that has nothing to do with the game, to be honest. You're going to medical school because you've been inspired by said game, if that's the case. If anything, that's a positive. But for you to turn around like, ha ha ha, I'm going to medical school, that's actually pretty shallow of you. You couldn't just take solace in saying, hey, look, this game was so inspiring to me that it made me want to change my life decision. Thank you, Blizzard. Couldn't have went there, could you? No. Instead, you decide to take the petty route, the immature route, and try to bag on gamers. And that's why I said it's not about going to Harvard Medical School. It's about taking shots at video gamers once again. You're not fooling me. Not at all. But within all of this, you know, get good mentality, you know, all these sites like Polygon, oh my god, they're telling us to get good, it's toxic, blah, blah, blah. Why did you turn around right afterwards and tell people how not to suck at Overwatch? So complain about people telling you to get good, then your friends come in, swoop, and help you like they're the fucking Justice League and say, don't you tell them to get good, then you turn around yourself and tell others to get good. I swear, it's like Uno. It's like someone threw a draw four at you and you got mad, and then when you picked one up yourself, you threw it back at them. That's what it feels like at this point. It's absolutely ridiculous. But speaking of getting good, I guess we can move on from here and we can talk about the FGC. That's right, because a number of you really do need to get good. That's right. And it's about your mentality. That's right. Not about gameplay, not about your skills, but your actual mentality. But since I just mentioned the Justice League, I guess we can talk about that first, shall we? So, Injustice 2 has been officially announced. Now, at first they said they were going to announce this at E3, okay? I'll put that link in the info bar. But as we know, the trailer has come out today, and everyone is already saying it's Triborg. You know, God's among us. But here's the question for people who are hyped about Injustice 2. Because if you remember, with Injustice 1, everyone loved Injustice 1. Everyone was so hyped. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And then MKX came along. And as soon as MKX came along, Injustice died. It flatlined completely. People just stopped playing it. So I have to ask the NRS community, once Injustice 2 hits, will you be able to handle two games? That's the question. Will MKXL just die? Will it just die and just all of a sudden just move over and migrate back over to Injustice 2? Or will you be able to juggle MKXL and Injustice 2? Because given the track record, what happened not too long ago, you weren't able to do that. Everyone just left Injustice and just went right over to MKX. It was like a placeholder until MKX came out. And that's pretty sad, because you should know by now that if you want these games to survive, you have to keep supporting them in the long run. This is a problem I've seen as of late when it comes to the fighting game community. Because a lot of people talk about longevity of fighting games. You have to understand, back in the day, there's still people out there who play Power Stone. There's still people out there who play rival schools. You know what I mean? There's still people out there who still support these games. Marvel vs. Capcom 2. You know what I mean? Darkstalkers. Stuff like that. King of Fighters 94. You know what I mean? Like, there's people who still 98. You know what I mean? Dream Match. Like, there's people who still play these games. Battle Royale Shinden. You know what I mean? Air Guys. You know what I mean? There's people who still play this stuff. It still has a dedicated fan base. And for something so new as Injustice, the first one to come out, and it just flatlined like that, it's absolutely crazy. That's absolutely crazy. It's unheard of that it would die so quickly. So I'm hoping that maybe the NRS community this time around will catch it and be like, okay, you know what? We can do both and we can have longevity for both. I'm sure, as you know, Injustice 2 has, like I said, it's been announced, it'll come out next year. We're going to see people now go back to Injustice 1 so they can get that warm up, because you know that's what fighting games, that's what players do. You know, if a new game is announced for said, you know, series, they always go back to the older one to get a good feel for it, a good warm up, and then they go back, you know, when the new one's released, they go to that one. That's what they do. Same thing what's happening with King of Fighters. You notice King of Fighters 14 has been announced. What are people doing? They're playing King of Fighters 13 again. Just to keep that warm up, to get that feel again. You know what I mean? That's what people do. So, let's move on. In more news, Under Night and Birth, summer update to add new character Mika. We will see what comes with that. Okay, we'll see. I've seen the character. I'm not sold on it just yet. You know what I mean? I need to see more of Mika, or in order for me to be like, oh, okay, you know. I've just seen screenshots. I haven't seen it in motion yet. And I'll admit that. I've only seen screenshots. So maybe the character will be good. We'll see what happens. All right? Also, in Yomi news. That's right. Yomi Gaming opens arcade doors to the public. So, for those who know, they have opened their doors to the public. I would suggest that if anyone's, you know, have seen Yomi Gaming, I've seen what it looks like. Go during the day. I would say that. Go during the day. Yeah. So, yeah, but they're open now, you know, to the public. By all means, go. See how it's going. Meet the people. Meet the players. Have fun. You know what I mean? Also, in more news, all right, I guess this is where we have to get the, you know, to get good mentality, because, you know, that's why people don't take gaming so seriously. Lupe, that's right, Senpai Lupe, that's what they call him these days. Senpai Lupe admits to match fixing with Daigo. Now, as you can see, he was asked, you know, would you ever play Filipino champ, because, you know, he's beaten Daigo before, and Lupe said, well, but mine was fixed. Obviously, he's saying it sarcastically, but as you know, we know it was fixed. So, because he can't convince anybody that he really did beat Daigo, he's going to say that, come on, he's going to say, we know it's the truth. But he can get away with saying these type of things, because no matter what he says, people aren't going to believe him anyway. We knew it was fixed. We knew what he did, okay? But there's more. When Filipino champ is decided, you know, when he's brought up and Lupe talks about him, he gets all starstruck. That's right. Once again, get starstruck, and here we go with the ass kissing. Are you fucking kidding me? Is this serious? I mean, let's be honest here, all right? There is nothing street about Filipino champ, and there's nothing G about his ass either, all right? Because the last I checked, it wasn't street or G to shake a man's hand and then go run to go talk to somebody behind their back after you shook their fucking hand. I ain't trying to hear that. That's some punk shit, okay? Nothing street, nothing G about Filipino champ, all right, Lupe? But I do want to bring up the fact that, you know, Filipino champ's like, oh my god, I made it because I made the Lupe's tweets. Have you noticed that the people who make the FGC look bad always circle jerk each other? Have you noticed that? But there's more to this, because, like I said, if you think that that's what, that can, you know, constitute you making it, because some douchebag, you know, talked, I won't even say even talked about you. All he said was, you know, but my fight was fixed. That's all he said. You know what I mean? But apparently that's enough to, you know, to make you turn into a fanboy or a fangirl, you know, one of those boy band groupies and start screaming, oh my god! That's what you acted like right there. It's absolutely pathetic that this is what it's about. But there's more. Oh, there's more, all right? Because like I said, people who make the FGC look bad, as you know, the FGC, as of late, have trying to become esports. We know this. But no, no, no. The people who say that Senpai Lupe is putting the FGC on his back. Remember that? He's putting it on his back. He tells you, FGC people, or you players, or you, even you top-tier players, guess what? That the FGC isn't esports. You're not esports. That's right. He comes out and says that, and says that it is savagery at its finest. That's what he says. So the FGC isn't esports, huh? I wonder what Markman would think about that. I put it like this. Lupe, you do realize the reason why you were brought in to play Daigo was to make the FGC more popular, because they're trying to make the push to esports. You fucking idiot. You think because they're having all these venues and they're having these bigger venues, you think they're just doing this just for the fucking sake of it? No! It's the fact that they're trying to become esports. People are trying to get paid. There's a reason they got sponsors and all this shit. And you want to sit here and say, it's not esports, it's savagery at its finest. So you're promoting the negative part of gaming, of the FGC. And if you haven't seen it through those comments in that picture, yeah, People are agreeing with him. Yo, we keeps it real in the FGC, dog. We keeps it real. We know how to have a good time. It's just, unfortunately, people don't see that. You really want to go there? Do you really want to fucking go there? Because I put it like this. You want to say that having a good time. So, people who have been berated, people who have been bullied, people who have been yelled at, people who have been throwing controllers and snapping out and popping off and getting into fights. Hell, one guy was banned for stabbing somebody. But that is all about having a good time, huh? That's having a good time. Acting like a fucking idiot is having a good time. That's what you're saying. Are you serious? This is how far you're willing to go to kiss some guy's ass who just came in here all of a couple minutes ago? This is how far you're willing to go. And for you to say that's keeping it real, yeah, keeping it real fucking stupid. Keeping it real fucking immature. I can't believe that there's people out there who actually believe this dumb shit. But apparently there are. Because I'm going to show you even more examples today. Oh, yeah. More examples of immaturity. And I know, FGC, I know what I'm saying right now. I know it hurts. I know it does. And I know a number of you in the community are saying, it's not all of us. I understand that. It's not all of you. But the people that you hold up high, those are the people that are making this what it is. Because you keep them there. You would think when people start acting this way, you say, oh, nope, get the fuck out. You're done. But no. Still got to keep them up top, and the people that are on top, like I said, once again, have to keep circle jerking each other because their plan is to stay on top. They don't care about our community. Clearly, you can see they don't give a shit about our community. You know, it's not about moving forward. No, no. It's not about making things better. It's about keeping it real, keeping it savage, keeping it the fuck out of here, this old bullshit. And the thing is, with esports, let's be honest here, all right? Just because people are going esports, it doesn't mean that it's esports is the most tame either. I mean, we've seen it in the FPS community as well, how people act a fool when they're trying to get into esports.
You're so fucking annoying! I'm gonna fucking...
This is why I wanted...
That's a fucking teacher!
Oh my god, dude!
That's a fucking teacher! What the fuck, dude? What the fuck are you doing to the TV? Bro, what? Fuck out of here, dude! Bro, what? Dude, chill! Chill! Bro!
Oh! Oh my god, pussy. I hit a fucking crane shot!
You fucking pussy!
Yo, what the fuck did you just do?
Oh, you hit a fucking shot?
Bro, did you just smash my fucking TV?
Oh, shit!
Oh, but there's more. Yeah, there's more. See, for you to say, Lupe, that FGC isn't trying to be esports and he shouldn't be esports because Senpai Lupe says so, here's one for you. Panda Global Gaming signs MKXL player Scar. That's right. But he is prohibited from doing fatalities. That's right. So, let's have this talk. Because esports, sponsorship. Yeah, he's not allowed to do fatalities. And people are like, what the hell? Why can't he do fatalities? Because you can't show those type of things on TV when it comes to esports. That's right. If Disney is airing something on their family channel and they're trying to show, you know, MLG or FGC gaming, because that's the FGC member. They didn't want to be MLG. They wanted to break off and do their own thing. And then when they saw MLG be so big and they're making all this money, they said, okay, now we want to get popular too. We want the money too. So, because you have to deal with these companies, I told you before this is how it was going to go. Because it seems like nobody has any type of fucking sense about business, okay? That this is going to happen. You can't curse on TV. You can't act a fool on TV. You can't be savage on TV. Mm-mm. You can't do that shit on family TV, on ESPN. You can't do that. TBS or anything. No. Because if you're showing that type of stuff, you have to understand they can be fined for regulations, alright? You can't show but so much gory stuff on Family Center TV. They work so hard to get that PG rating or that G rating or whatever rating. You have to understand that. Now, if this was something like cable, like Showtime or HBO, yeah, you could get away with it, okay? AMC does a pretty good job of getting away with stuff like that, you know, with The Walking Dead. But you have to understand that type of violence, when you're pushing it towards kids, because that's who's watching it, that's your demographic. Regardless how much you want to sit here and say it's not, you adults, you're pandering to kids. That's how the stations see it, okay? That's how they see it. That's the demographic. And when you're showing stuff like that, then guess what? It's a problem. Now, of course, there's some people saying, well, you know, MKXL is an M-rated game. You should be able to do those type of things. Yes, but you have to understand that these sponsors don't see it that way. The only reason that MKX or MKXL or whatever you want to call it is being put on TV is because of its popularity. That's why. It has nothing to do with an M rating. They will try to make it as low as possible. Did you notice? Even on Conan, they weren't showing that type of stuff, really. You know what I mean? When he was having the celebrities come, you know, come and do that type of stuff. You had to pretty much watch it online. You can only do but so much. Late night, you can get away with a little bit more than you can with, you know, at regular time. But as you know, ESPN2, Sunday morning, here come esports. They have it on. You know what I mean? So you can't show that type of stuff. And I know you're saying, Event, this is wrong. It shouldn't be this way. This is business. This is big business. This is how they do business. And I've been telling you this for how long? And you haven't fucking listened. Now, all these things are happening, and you want to act like you're blindsided by them. That's the funny part. And I guess we should talk about that. Because even though Senpai Lupe has been acting this way, as you know, he's been threatening people, you know, to hurt them in the hospital, you know, over Street Fighter matches. And you see these type of things. You know how negative he's being. You see it all the time. Yet you people still want to parade him around. Matter of fact, you're playing kick-push at said tournament that you're holding. Then the fucking idiot goes to Combo Breaker, and what happens? Everybody wants to go and run and get a picture with him. Oh, look, it's that Snake Markman. You know, the same guy who said, I don't condone violence in the FGC, real violence. And then when we showed him the stuff about Lupe, what did he do? He did nothing. Because we said, you know, you should call him out. There should be a punishment for him acting this way, talking about putting people in the hospital over Street Fighter challenges. But you didn't do anything, did you, Markman? Matter of fact, the opposite happened. What you did was you sent him a bunch of shit. A bunch, and we saw that not too long ago. Big crate full of stuff for Street Fighter V. Now he's going to Combo Breaker, and you're taking pictures. Yeah, dog. What's up? What's going on? It's hype in here now. Everybody wants a piece of the fucking celebrity, if you have not realized. Is this even about video games anymore? Is this about the competition anymore? About loving fighting games? Or is this just about now just kissing ass? Because it just seems like that at these points. You know, well, he's a celebrity. We should just listen to him. Because he's a celebrity. Hasn't proven shit. Doesn't know what the fuck he's talking about. But we're going to kiss his ass anyway, right? But it gets worse. That's right. For those who don't know. Then this fool decides, since he's at Combo Breaker, he's going to sit in the fucking crowd with all the gamers. You know, the very same gamers that he said, all you in the FGC, you can all suck a dick and die. So this clown is sitting in the crowd. Right there, alright, after telling y'all ain't shit, has repeatedly ducked fights because he says he's the man, he's the guy, he's on the top of the leaderboard, right? You're gonna tell me not one person, not one, went over to him and said, look, what you're doing I feel is wrong, let's have this matchup, I'm calling you out, because you know, that's what we did back in the day in the arcades, you know, yo, I heard you the man here, I want to play you. You gonna tell me not one person did that? Not one? I'm wondering if everyone's just lost their fucking heart, lost their backbone. I don't want to hear that this guy was hard to get at. He was hard to get to, security or whatever. Not trying to hear that. Clearly, he's sitting in the crowd with everyone else. Not one person did that, huh? Out of all the challenges that he ducked, those players, you'll tell me none of those players was like, look, let's do this right now. Man, we got a camera right here, let's do it right now. Impromptu, let's do it. You know, like we used to do. It's a fucking joke. It is. Like I said, but if I talk about your precious Street Fighter V and how it's shit, then, you know, I'm trying to assassinate Capcom and I'm nothing but entitled and I'm spoiled and all the bullshit, right? Right? Yeah. Everyone has the heart to say something online. Nobody, it seems, has the heart to even challenge somebody to a game in person. How is that? I don't understand that. But, okay. Let's move on more about Combo Breaker, and I guess we have to talk about this because something very bad happened at Combo Breaker. That's right. For those who don't know, Noel Brown has been banned from Capcom Pro Tour for groping a woman. That's right. And for those who did not see this happen, I want you to pay attention. On the right side, you're going to see a guy in a white t-shirt grab this woman's ass. Okay? So, let's look at the video. Now, if you look at the video, yeah, he grabbed her ass. He didn't full hand grab ass. He goosed her. He goosed her. He did. A little quick goose. He did. So, yeah, there's nothing you can do about it. He did. However, the stories that we've been hearing online is just ridiculous. Some people are going as far as say that he raped her. Like, no, he didn't. Stop. All right? Stop that. All right? No way did he do that. That's absolutely wrong. However, you have to understand that a lot of people are upset about this because apparently he did not have consent. When I first saw the video, I thought they were together. I really thought they were. Or he was just trying to sneak one and act like, you know, I don't know what I'm doing. So I really wanted to find out if they knew each other. Apparently they knew each other. And people are saying that she grabbed his ass the night before and, it, you know, he thought it was okay. And that's not, you know, apparently she's someone else's girlfriend. And look, I'll put it like this, all right? If he didn't have consent, he should have kept his hands to himself. Bottom line. But you also have to understand, given his history of what he has done in the FGC. And like I said, you can't just keep looking at stuff as he's a good player or an adequate player and that overshadows everything. Given the fact that he has punched people in the past or and what people are telling me, he had to go to court for beating up his ex-girlfriend or something. Look, when you have a history like this, it's going to always stick with you. So, when something does bad happen and you feel as though it's not your fault, it's too late because you have a track record of doing things and it keeps up with you. That's what it is. Now, for what I've seen with people online, they're saying, good, he deserves to be banned. He should be banned for life. That's what people are saying, because for those who don't know, Capcom Pro Tour has only banned him temporarily. That's what it is. It's temporarily. We will see what happens in the future. If, given his track record, because they're saying it's a first-time offense. No, given his history, it's not a first-time offense. So, if he doesn't have any clear care of what's going on of the people around him, because he's only caring about himself, then yeah, he does need to be banned for life. He does, okay? The fact is, though, look, I'll put it like this. When you're seeing people come to his defense over this, and in the most disgusting and vulgar way, and this is where, like I said, I have to show you examples of what I mean about this community and how it's a problem. This isn't Savage at its finest, okay? These are people who don't deserve to even be in this community. So I guess we should start with the comments. Here's the problem. It doesn't fucking matter if she's fat, if she's skinny, if she's attractive, if she's not attractive. Keep your fucking hands to yourself. That's all you gotta do. That's all you gotta do. But yet, for some reason, these people want to try and say it's not justifiable because, you know, you're losing your career over some fat chick. So if she was attractive and he did it, then you'd be like, I can see why he did that. That's what you're saying right now. You can't be this fucking stupid. Once again, the immaturity in this community, it has to fucking go. And when I see shit like that, it tells me, because you're grasping at fucking straws on why it should have been okay if she was attractive. That's what it's implying, okay? And when you have those type of people, those are the type of people you don't want at your tournaments, at your events, when they have that type of mindset. But yet, there's more. Yes, idiot, because you shouldn't put your hands on anybody. For you to say, this is correct behavior, yeah. I want you to go outside and just randomly put your hands on people. Go ahead, see what happens. Watch what the fuck happens to you. See, that's what you fail to realize. Women, especially, right? You just can't walk over to them like, I'm just going to grab that ass. Oh, no, they're going to turn around. They're going to give you an earful and slap the piss out of you, all right? You put your hands on a man out of nowhere, guess what's going to happen? You're going to get punched, son. For you to say, this is correct behavior, like you don't fucking know. It's common sense. Keep your hands to your fucking self. Unless you got consent, keep your hands to yourself. Now, if this is an issue of, I thought I had consent because of what happened, and it's he said, she said, then guess what? Like I said, given your past history, given this guy's past history, no one's going to believe him. Like I said, I see so much hatred towards this guy, you know, when it comes to online. He should be banned for life. He deserves everything he gets. He shouldn't be in the community. So many people are saying this. Of course, you know, the top guys, they're not going to say shit because, once again, when serious issues happen, you know, hey, we're just going to keep quiet on things because I don't want to rock the boat, you know what I mean? I got my own business. Like I said, they don't give a shit about the community. However, it was interesting to see a tournament organizer come out and say something, you know what I mean? But then again, the tournament organizers, when you have Lupe Fiasco there, who has said that he's going to hurt somebody, it kind of hurts, you know, what you're actually trying to, you know, the message you're trying to portray because it makes you look like a hypocrite. It does. I don't understand how this can get any worse, but it does. That's right. I say this because Capcom actually taking the right steps because they revised their rules and regulations on this situation, and apparently people are having a problem with that. So let's get into this, okay? Yeah, let's get into this. The new rules as follows with Capcom's Pro Tour. Swearing and screaming or threats. You will be kicked out for this. If you swear, if you scream, if you have any threats. So, Lupe, you should be thrown out. Filipino champ, you should be thrown out. All these type of people that you love so much should be thrown out. Just saying. Okay? The new rules. Harassment. Well, Looks like a lot of people gonna be thrown out on that one. Violence. A lot of people gonna be thrown out on that one. Collusion. A lot of people gonna be thrown out on that one. Cheating of any sort through any means. Get thrown out, okay? Intentionally delaying or slowing gameplay. Get thrown out, okay? Intentionally disconnecting network cables. Get thrown out, all right? Intentionally interrupting network connectivity. Get fucking thrown out. Oh, there's more. Any other known or unknown manner of tampering with gameplay. Get tossed, all right? Any other type of conduct deemed inappropriate at Capcom's sole discretion. Get the fuck out. I love this, Capcom. You finally do something right. You do. Because, see, people are so upset about this. That's right. Because, you know, this is a big business now, esports, and they're putting a lot of money into this. This is an investment, okay? You have to understand that, because that's what these players are. They're investments. If you want to be esports, and you want to be treated as athletes, you can ask any fucking athlete. When they sign on that contract, their owner will tell them they are an investment. That's why when someone gets hurt, like a basketball, oh, I hurt my pinky, they're out for like 2 weeks or 3 weeks because they want to make sure they can play at the highest level. Why? Because they're an investment, so they treat them with kid gloves. That's why. And of course, they have to follow their rules and regulations, because if they don't, then they get either fined, they get suspended, they get thrown off the team. We've seen a lot of this stuff. So FGC players, for those who are so mad, I'm going to show you more because the crying has just been great as far as I'm concerned, all right? For you to act this way, it tells me you don't know shit about real life. You don't know shit about what you're getting yourselves into when it comes to esports. And it's time that you stop fighting over said fucking video game and come together and say, you know what? We need to find a way that we can do this and make it better. And adjust to what they're giving us. Because if you haven't realized, these rules that you're seeing, no swearing, no yelling and all this stuff, guess what? This is what they do in Japan, okay? And I say that because if you watch any type of sport in Japan, judo, MMA, if you watch, hell, even pro wrestling, they sit there and every time something's executed, oh, that's all they do. If you haven't noticed, the fact is, this is what they want to do. This is the way they want to shape things. You have to comply. If you don't comply, then guess what? Don't compete. You had for years and years your way of acting like fucking idiots. Savage, just keeping it real. You had your way for years, and you embarrassed yourselves. Now, it's changing. And you're going to tell me you can't make that adaption? You're going to tell me you can't stop acting that way? You're going to tell me you can't be an adult? Because if you can't, get the fuck out. Let's move on, because there's more, because people are complaining, that's right. The new regulations kill sponsorship in the FGC when it comes to Capcom. That's right, there's an article that's actually written, because Bud Light is gone. How dare they get rid of Bud Light? And we just talked about this not too long ago, how they were getting rid of the porn sponsors, but yet they were keeping the alcohol sponsors. And people were like, well, that's just wrong. I said, you know, you can't keep one or the other. Well, now they're getting rid of both. So it goes to show you, because like I said, you have to understand, you were going to be on this with kids. You have to understand that. And then you say, well, the NFL does it, the MLB does it. Yes, they do it, but you have to understand that they have a larger demographic than fighting games do or esports does. That's why. You notice it's the reason why they were pushing Doritos in your face and energy drinks in your face, even though this shit will kill you. You should know the fact that they were pushing that shit instead of alcohol. There's a reason. Jesus fucking Christ. But no. We should, you know, the writer's talking about how, you know, you should probably, you know, make a deal with combos and stuff like that. And I'm thinking to myself, that's just more fucking junk. I could understand more if you went the other route, you know, with like energy bars or like Cliff bars or something like that, you know, because you still want to maintain some type of integrity. Because all you're doing when you have Bud Light and Doritos and Mountain Dew and all that other shit, mind you, Mountain Dew banned in a lot of fucking countries, all right, because of the shit that's in it. You have to understand that when you want junk, it makes you look like the fat, overweight gamer who sits around for 14 hours a day and plays fucking video games. You're not breaking the stereotype, okay? But no one wants to hear that either, right? But there's more. That's right. Let's talk about the FGC, because apparently, since Overwatch has come out, Overwatch has taken over, and apparently, people in the FGC are upset. They're blaming Overwatch for the downfall of the FGC. And then some people say, well, no, actually, it's Capcom that's the downfall of it. So first blame Overwatch, okay? First blame Overwatch, because, you know, it's fun. and then blame Capcom for making these rules for you to act like a stand-up citizen and adult, and say that they're killing the entire FGC. So for all these years, the FGC has been around, and Capcom's new rules all of a sudden is just killing it, huh? That's what you fucking want to say. As if Capcom is the only game in town. That's what you want to say, you know, because no other fighting games count. Granted, Street Fighter is very popular, but don't act like it's the fucking end-all, be-all. This is what we call overreacting, fanboys, and also immaturity. Instead of sitting here and saying, hey, we need to look at ourselves because the way we've acted over the years, no. Let's throw shade on Overwatch, let's throw shade on Capcom. Not to mention, these rules that they put in place wouldn't even be a factor if you didn't act like a bunch of fucking idiots. But don't look at yourselves, right? No, not at all. Don't look at yourselves and say, okay, we've got a problem in our community. No, not at all. Because you love that shit, right? Because it's savage, it's keeping it real, dog. It's keeping it real. Fucking stupid. I'm surrounded in this community by fucking children. That's what it feels like. By children. I've tried to warn you time and time again that this is where esports was going to go. And all it takes is one person to fuck it up for everyone. And that you should adjust and get ready and prepare. And once again, you act like you're fucking blindsided. But there's more. Speaking of Overwatch, because the FGC, because apparently you're so mad at Overwatch, we now have people telling others that are playing Overwatch, please, please stop playing Overwatch and come back to Street Fighter V, please, please. So you want people to stop playing what they enjoy, what they paid for, to come back and play Street Fighter V because that's what you want. Are you fucking serious? This desperation is absolutely ridiculous. Look, Street Fighter V is not going anywhere, okay? Overwatch is not going anywhere. Let people have their fun. They have the right to play whatever the fuck they want, okay? They have the right. They bought the game. You think they're going to buy the game and not play it? I mean, seriously. Just stop playing Overwatch. Come on. Stop, FGC. It's fucking pathetic. It is. You've got to be kidding me that you have not seen this coming. You know what? There's more to this when I say pathetic. Because once again, you're going to act like you didn't know this was coming, okay? So let's talk about this. I had told you how many times I've said in video, when someone got banned at a place, you know, at an arcade, you know, other arcades, called other arcades and told them, look, don't let this person in. That's how it was. That's how old school it was back in the day. So if you fucked up, you were done, right? For those who don't know, Ultra Arcade has released Noelle Brown. That's right. So Capcom has also said anyone else at any other tournament that, you know, wants to ban him, they will fully back them on, okay? So as you can see, making the rounds. We'll see how far this goes, of course. You know what I mean? We'll see how many tournaments we'll be allowed to go to. And, you know, in the future, we'll see. You know, how many people want to ban them, how many people won't. But you have to understand that this is the way things were done. So, if everyone falls in line and starts banning them, don't get upset. Like I said, you only have yourself to blame for this. But no one wants to see it that way. It's obviously Capcom's new rules that it's a problem, and I can't believe they're doing this. Because you don't know how to act when you're playing a fucking video game. You gonna tell me if you win, you can't turn to the person and say, hey man, good game, pat on the back, shake your hand, you can't do that. No, you got to get up, you got to yell in your face. You know, if you get mad, you got to throw shit and carry on. That's what you're complaining about right now. Think about that. I gotta get in someone's face because I think I can beat them. And we're just gonna yell like this is fucking wrestling. Once again, I told you before, that shit is fake. But keeping it real. Okay, let's move on. You wanna talk about keeping it real? I'm sure you already see it in the header about what's going on. We need to talk about the Smash community, okay? So, Smash is Kibikuru plans murder-suicide, okay? I'm sure you already see it up there. CEO, Evo, this is a problem. Now, let's talk about this because Kibikuru, I'm just gonna say Kiwi for now on. Because it's just shorter. We have to say that Kiwi was outed not too long ago as being a fraud. And what I mean by that is, this woman, or this girl, I can't even call her a woman. This girl, okay, this child, would use her charms to get her way. Sounds familiar, doesn't it? We see this a lot. She would use her charms to get her way, to get what she wants, to be liked in the community, okay? But the real part of her is actually very apathetic. Apparently, she got to a point where she was abusing other people, you know, who were supposedly were her friends in the community, in the Smash community. Now, mind you, even though she's not much of a big Smash player, she's more of an artist, okay? But as the story goes. I'm going to put the link in the info bar. You have to understand that this story is so long. This is like a 7-page story filled with screenshots and people admitting that they want others to die and how they're looking into killing them and stuff like that. Like I said, it is a very big issue. I would suggest, just to let you know, I would suggest that you read it because it's very important, okay? But she goes on to abuse other players, okay, and roasting players. And once again, we see this excuse, just like David Jaffe, where people say, hey, look, you're going at this guy way too hard. You know what I mean? And she was like, but other players roast, you know, people. The community roast each other. I just thought it was okay to do. Like, she's telling people who are depressed to go and kill themselves. You know what I mean? Then when she's outed as being a fraud, because all these things are screenshotted and see the way she acts towards people and how much of a nasty attitude she has, people distance themselves away from her, right? So she gets upset about that because she feels people are taking a said person's side as opposed to, you know, her actions and her statements of what she's done. So she starts drawing, you know, people. First off, she starts drawing their characters as dead, which to me is nothing, all right? You want to draw Peach dead or whatever, whatever. Not that big of a deal. But there's, like I said, bigger issue, all right? But then she starts drawing players as though she's killed them. Then she starts talking about how she has people's addresses and how she can get firearms and how she wants to shoot them. And apparently, at one point, it got so bad, they had to start banning her from 2GGT Mexico Saga. Apparently, this girl has some serious issues. Not only does she talk about killing other people, but she talks about killing herself. She talks about how her parents, now that they have to move in, they're going to keep her under a microscope because of the way she acts. She talks about how she can't lash out. She can't punch a pillow. She obviously has some mental issues. So while I'm talking about this, don't think I'm speaking on this issue simply to vilify her. You know what I mean? To make her such the bad guy. And no, clearly, this is for the safety of others. This is for the safety of herself. She needs help. She does. And for her to just be able to say, I can get a firearm with no problem. See, it's not like she's going to an event and saying, I'm going to beat you up or I'm going to choke you or whatever. And you think, yeah, whatever. You ain't going to do shit. You know what I mean? But the fact that you have such easy access to firearms, anybody can just grab a gun, point and shoot with no problems. You know what I mean? And that's what we call coward shit. You know what I mean? But she doesn't have a care in the world about this. She doesn't care who she harms. She doesn't care who she shoots. She talks about going on mass shootings and killing people. And you have to understand, these are at events. So you have people who aren't even in entries or players. You've got families there and kids there who want to watch Smash and stuff like that. You can't have this happen there. And the fact that she's talking about going to CEO in Evo, and she's already been banned from one event, she needs to be banned from all events, as far as I'm concerned, until this is, you know, until she gets some help. So as far as I'm concerned, this is for the safety of others. And this is a problem. Like I said, I'm not trying to hear, and the thing is, here's the problem. What I said earlier in the beginning of the video, how people talk about how they love this community, but when serious issues happen, they don't take it seriously. They don't, you know what I mean, they just turn a blind eye and head in the sand and stuff like that. What I'm getting ready to show you is people who say that Smash Bros., don't nobody care about y'all enough to kill y'all, blah, 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 not taking any of this shit seriously, even though she's been banned already. Once again, the immaturity. Nobody said anything about people being celebrities. This is about her holding a grudge towards people and people just in life that she doesn't know. She has no, you know, no care for whatsoever. She doesn't care about her actions. She doesn't care about any type of responsibility. She wants to see people die, and she feels as though that's something that would please her. Now, of course, when you read this, like I said, I hope that you read this 7-page, this story that I'm going to put in the info bar for you, and you understand that some of it does sound just a bit edgy and she's just acting. It sounds like it. But when you start getting people's addresses, and you start having, you know, you start buying firearms and stuff like that, where you can get easy access to firearms, then you have to take it seriously. You just have to. And the fact, like I said, the fact that she's already been banned from one event, I would hate for her to go to CEO or Evo and do something so bad that it will reflect on our community. It would just be horrible. You know how much gaming in general would take a hit for that if she did something? The violence in video games, see? Mass murder, see? They turn people into killers. Not to mention the fighting game community in general. See, this is why you can't have this type of stuff, because they're so savage and keeping it real. And I don't know how many times I keep saying that. But it's just, it goes to show you that this is a problem that needs to be taken care of. It's already been stopped at one event. The other events haven't happened yet. This is your chance to stop it before it happens. And I don't want to hear, well, like I said, she's just being edgy or whatever. We shouldn't take care of this. No, this is clearly something that should be addressed. Clearly. When you've gone this far already, it's something that needs to be taken care of. So as far as I'm concerned, maybe it needs to be spread to the tournament organizers. Let them know what's going on. You don't have to send it to every fighting game player in the community. Send it to the organizers. Let them know. This is a problem. And it doesn't matter what game she's playing either. Because, you know, people say, well, the Smash community is some of the most savage. It doesn't matter what community it is. It doesn't matter. It's the fact that this is still a problem and it can happen. And why not take the necessary steps to make sure it doesn't happen before it gets to the point and it happens? Then you'd be like, man, this didn't need to happen. This is fucked up. Blah, blah, blah. This is your warning. Let's move on. Like I said, link will be in the info bar for it. Let's move on. I'm done with the FGC. This week has been really bad for the FGC. It just has. And I can only imagine how many people are going to jump on me just for everything I've addressed, even though it's the right thing to do. Capcom did the right thing. These players, like I said, people in the community that put this together, that, like I said, that 7-page, you know what I mean, story with all the screenshots and stuff, it took people in the community to put that together, meaning they give a shit. It's not about being fucking fragile. It's not about saying, oh, you're sensitive. It's not about that. It's about doing what's right. But it seems as though people still don't understand it. Well, if it's not happening to me, then it don't matter. What's going to happen if you're there and it does happen to you? Then what? Then would you take it seriously? It'd be too late then, wouldn't it? I don't know how this is a community if we have so many fucking idiots act this way. I just don't understand it. And granted, you're going to have your bad spot, you know, your bad people with your good people and all that, but you do your best to just get rid of those people. Oh my God, we can't curse or swear anymore. Act the fucking fool. Capcom has killed the FGC. Unreal. Unreal. Let's move on. Ninja Theory. I said I'd talk about this. Ninja Theory's Hellblade Collector's Edition won't have a physical disc. You fucking serious? Look, Ninja Theory. It's bad enough you've taken so much flack for the last game you made with Devil May Cry. Now you're going to... Your Collector's Edition, you're not having a physical copy? Are you fucking stupid? Okay, you know what? This is why people don't like Ninja Theory at this point. It's not even about their fanboys and fangirls who will defend them till the end, because, of course, everything they fucking do, people will love when it comes to that type of fandom. It's absolutely ridiculous. I don't know where they're headed. Obviously, their head's up their ass. But you've got to be kidding me that you're paying this much money for a collector's edition and you're not getting a physical copy for the fucking game. Let's move on. Speaking of more bad games. And I say this, but yeah, I say it, because that taints the fucking game in general. I don't even know anything about that game. Listen, I don't care about the game. So it's not like I'm going to spend my time bagging on Ninja Theory for something that they're trying to create. It's not like that. It's not like with Devil May Cry, where they took something that had, you know, a history and just fucked it completely. This is something that they're doing on their own, and you're not going to give people a physical... Okay. Let's move on. Watch Dogs 2. Let's talk about this. Watch Dogs 2 will make big changes, says Ubisoft. So you mean, like, the game will work when... At launch, it'll work. It won't have all the bugs and stuff. That's the big changes you're making? Is that it? Also, Ubisoft, I don't think you should be worried much about Watch Dogs 2 making big changes when you should just be cleaning up the stuff. Because for those who don't know, it's getting ready to be a takeover in Vivendi. And Ubisoft is scared shitless right now because they don't know what's going to happen with them. That's what you should be worried about. Let's move on to more bad news. Like I said, I want to get all the bad news out the way and then the good news. So, let's talk about... Metal Gear Solid Snake Eater. That's right. Konami has brought Metal Gear Solid Snake Eater back, but it's a pachinko machine. You know, Konami, I'm trying to figure out why. Why? You talk about how you want to get back in the fans' good graces, and then you don't do it. You go and you do this shit. Haven't you realized by now that your gamers, not your pachinko machines over in Japan, your gamers, they wanted Metal Gear, you fucked Metal Gear. Alright, you fucked Silent Hill. People still waiting for Contra. Konami, you've got to be kidding me. The only thing you have left was what? Pro Evolution Soccer? And you just got finished, was it? You just gave a warning to everyone who had 2015 that you're cutting the service for that. So you're taking her out of EA. Okay. Look, Konami, you need to get back in the good graces of fans, and you need to stop playing this bullshit. You do. And I know Konami said, well, if you look at the records, you know, for everyone who bought Phantom Pain, and all this, we made so much money. Yeah, because Kojima was behind it. That's why. So what are you going to do? So you going to give us another Revengeance? You going to go to Platinum? And without Kojima, is that what you're going to do? What do you have planned in the future? Because you keep talking about how you have more Metal Gear in the future. Konami, I think it's time that you actually sit down and talk with your fans and see how they feel. Not the people who are just going to yell at you. You fucking assholes. Well, no, I'm not talking about those people. Talk to the fans at E3. Have something. A Q&A. Please. And see what happens. Please. Because I put it like this. Konami, you're sitting on a lot of IPs that people like, and you're not doing anything with them. And at this point, the only thing that people remember is Metal Gear. Silent Hill, like I said, Contra. That's like what people remember these days, because it's all you've been pretty much shelling out for pretty much a couple of years, so people have forgotten. But Konami, you can do better than this. It's just sad that you would still do this. Anyways, in more news. This is actually pretty funny. Explorers uncover classic arcade games on an abandoned ship. That's right, pinball games, arcade games, on an abandoned ship. That's pretty cool. Don't know if they still work, but for them to, you know, to define that, that's really cool. Also, since we talked about Overwatch not too long ago, I guess we should talk about Overwatch. Alright, no Overwatch crossplay, but Blizzard is keeping an eye out for crossplay on consoles. Just to let you know, alright? Personally, I think as though they need to have it for PC, but then again, people who use mouse and keyboard will probably dominate controller players on console, so there's that as well, okay? Also, Blizzard is designed to ban Overwatch cheaters, even if they buy new copies of the game and format their computer. Jesus Christ. You know what? I'm for that. And I say this because, you know what? You shouldn't be cheating anyway. You don't need to cheat. Have fun, learn the game, get good. Kudos, Blizzard. Kudos. I ain't saying other people would say on how they're going to pull it off. That's a little risky because, you know, you're hurting your fan base. But no, they just want clean play. Maybe there's a better way you can go about it instead of just banning them and just wiping their, you know, they wipe their computer and it's still not enough. Formatting, it's not enough. They're still going to ban you. Maybe you can do something like CD Projekt did where you put, like, this unstoppable monster or something. Or maybe you can change their bullets or something, you know, when they're firing at you and it's not hurting anybody. And what the fuck, I'm shooting, it's not doing anything. Maybe you could do something like that. You know what I mean? Be a little bit more creative than just, you know, outright just, you know, oh, you gotta buy a new copy, and you're gonna wipe your system, and you still won't be able to play. Like, I don't know. Make it more creative. Make it more fun. Like, seriously. Make the people who are cheating stand out so you know they're cheaters. Not just, we're just gonna get rid of you that way. And if, like I said, I can see it from both sides. That's what it is. I'm playing devil's advocate, and I'm also seeing it from the other side as well. You know what I mean? I am for them banning them completely, but I can see why people would have an issue with it. That's why I wanted to cover both sides. Okay, let's move on. The Payday 3. That's right. Has been confirmed. Payday 3 has been confirmed. Has been acquired by Starbreeze. And here's the thing. Microtransactions have been eliminated. So, like I said, some good news are coming out now. Okay? However, with the good news, there are some bad news. And not because developers are fucking you over and things like that. No, no, no. Allison Road. Kind of sad. For those who don't know, it has been canceled. That's right. I was looking forward to Allison Road, but it's been canceled. And the company came out on Twitter and let everyone know that thank you for your, you know, support, thank you for your help, but this is something that we need to venture, and we're still waiting to hear why they've decided to cancel this venture. So this is what they said on Twitter. So yeah, really sad to hear what's going on with Allison Road. We will see in the future exactly why they are deciding to cancel this project. But let's move on, shall we? Let's talk about Deep Silver is bringing Killing Floor 2 to the PS4. So, there's that. Also, I will say, even though Allison Road has fallen, it's done, it's canceled, Visage, again, if you have not seen what Visage, I've showed the trailer before about Visage, if you haven't seen the latest screenshots, they look amazing. Visage is looking like it's really amping up to be something great, and they're comparing it to, for those who have not seen the movie, the Babadook, they're comparing it to, they actually have side-by-side screenshots of their game as opposed to the actual movie of the Babadook. I think this is going to be really good for Visage. This is looking, shaping up to be really great. So, I'm looking forward to that. Also, in more news, a fan-made Star Wars Battlefront 3 remake has been approved on Steam. That's right, it's been approved. Now, of course, the people are saying, they're not afraid that they'll get a cease and desist order by EA because it's already been approved on Steam. So we'll see. They're not worried about it whatsoever. However, it's looking pretty good. We'll see what happens in the future. Okay. Also, speaking of more things that are looking good in the future, we talked about this not too long ago. Dreamcast 2 prototype. That's right. A lot of you had said to me before, this isn't real. Stop talking about it. Well, here's the thing. Dreamcast 2 prototype reveal is coming soon. That's right. I'll put the link in the info bar. They're going to have a prototype, but it doesn't have it working. So, we will see what happens in the future. I know a lot of people are still not sold on this, and I understand that. But as long as it's news and it has a fighting chance to be an underdog, I don't care if it's a 1% chance. Guess what? I'm going to talk about it. That's how it is. Right? You understand? Well, you understand. This is what gaming is about. Right? It's about being the underdog and rising up to the challenge. We just talked about obstacles and things of that nature in the beginning of this video. Alright? It's always going to be hard to get some type of startup when you do something. But for these people to see it through, and now we're seeing a prototype, we're getting ready to see a prototype? By all means. You should be supporting this. You know what I mean? You should be happy that this is happening. Not just, I don't believe this is bullshit, blah, blah, blah. If you want to say, hey, let's see what happens, that's fine too. You know what I mean? You want to be critical? That's fine. But I'm not going to write this off completely yet. Let's keep going on. Speaking of not writing things off completely, this may hurt some people. This may. So, let's get to this. Chrono Trigger. That's right. Everyone, Chrono Trigger. Oh my God, Chrono Trigger. Yes, we know how great Chrono Trigger is. I have like 4 copies of Chrono Trigger here, all right? But Chrono Trigger director would love to see a remake. That's right. Meaning he would love to see an updated version of the game. Now, the question is, do you think that this would hurt this classic RPG? Because, as we know, Chrono Trigger is the real deal, alright? Chrono Trigger, and to an extent, for those, I don't know how many people liked it, but I enjoyed it, Chrono Cross. You know what I mean? So, it's like, it's interesting to see where they're going to take Chrono Trigger, but they would love to see a remake. We don't know if it'll get the Final Fantasy VII Square treatment that way, you know what I mean, episodic, but Chrono Trigger, I mean, maybe it could be good, that's one of those things that's very touchy, man. When you have classics, it's very hard to... Like I said, that may hurt some people. That may. But let's move on. For D&D people. That's right, for those who don't know. D&D Neverwinter is coming to the PS4 this summer. PS Plus is not required. And DLC is on the way. Just to let you know. Okay? So, coming to the PS4, D&D fans. Also, we're at the end of this video. I'm sure it's been long enough. But, I need to talk about one Wobba replay. For those who don't know, Wobba Replay, and I will put the link in the info bar, is a community center driven off of gaming, anime, and hip-hop. So you've got b-boying and stuff like that. You've got people playing video games. You've got people watching anime. And apparently, when I was at MomoCon, I had a chance to talk to the people there. And they were telling me, you know, you can come into the community center, because it's a large community center. You can come in, you can play any game you want for $5. You play all day if you want. They've got the Dreamcast. They've got all these different consoles, stuff from Japan. You can play. They're holding gaming tournaments there. Well, at least they're trying to hold gaming tournaments there. They need more support. And this is in Atlanta. So they need more support, you know, from the community. A community center who doesn't have a computer to support a community. It's crazy. But I'll put it like this. If we had something like that in Philly, I would be there in a heartbeat. We don't have anything like that here. And to see something like that go up and to have that much passion behind it, like I said, they have their own YouTube channel, they have their own website. I'll put the website, in the info bar so you can see it. They've already put up stuff on their YouTube channel so you can see exactly what the place looks like, you know, the videos, see what the place looks like, their gaming center looks like. They have people doing graffiti on the walls, they have people putting up Smash characters, Kirby, doing all types of anime type of stuff on the walls. These are people just coming in and just drawing on the walls. You know what I mean? Like, it's amazing to see how you can put all these different cultures together, and it works. It works. And the thing is, I've said to you before about playing games and how it would help, you know, people like me growing up to stay out of trouble because we didn't have these type of things. This is what I mean. You have that hip-hop mentality, and you have this b-boying and all this stuff going on. Everyone's cool. And then you have video games here, and then you have graffiti here, and then you have anime here. And it's just, it's everywhere, and it's all in one spot. And everyone is in great spirits. No one's being negative. Everyone's having fun. Like, for what I've seen, like the videos I've seen, it looks amazing. And I feel as though it needs more support. I would like to see more players go over there and play games, have tournaments, hold tournaments there. You know what I mean? Like, you know, and no names. You know what I mean? Because you should know, like I said before, when it comes to being a celebrity, or being a known person, you try and help your community out. And in this case, you know what I mean? Everyone likes to talk. I talk about myself. You know, hey, we don't have any arcades. What's going on? We need to have arcades back. And a lot of you are like, yeah, we need the arcades back. Well, now we're having a community center who is giving you somewhat of that experience, and you're not getting the response, the feedback that they need. So could you imagine if this was big, if this worked, if it was popular, how many other community centers would open up and we have the same thing? It's almost like a gaming lounge with hip-hop and b-boying. Like, come on. You can't ask for anything more, man. That is, for what I've seen, I feel as though, once again, it's the underdog trying to be bigger, you know, trying to rise to the occasion. That has been a thing this entire video. Well, that and the stupidity of others. But you should see it for what it is. Seriously, I feel as though this really needs to be supported. I mean, you don't even have to be a big person. Like I said, in reality, when you're walking down the street, I don't care how famous you are when it comes to playing video games, there's a lot of people in this world who are not going to know who the fuck you are. You're going to walk down the street and they're going, oh my God, it's such a... No. People are not going to look at you. You just keep walking and mind your business. But the fact in reality, when you walk into one of these centers or something, you're just a body, you're just a person. And they're just happy that you're there because you're a person. That's a big deal. It's a huge deal. You know? And for what these guys are doing, and they're living the dream right now. They are. They're living the dream. And they say, hey, we want to get this up, and it's working. My hat's off to them. Seriously. Like, I just wish that we saw more support for things like that. So by all means, please, people, look at the website. Look at what they have to offer. Look at what they're doing. You know, watch the videos, because the videos aren't that long. 4 minutes, maybe, if that. Not long. They tell you what they're about. They show you the stuff, you know. They show you the actual place. They show you, you know, the setups and all that type of stuff. Seriously. It's for a place for people to be safe. And I don't mean a safe space. I mean to be safe, can be comfortable with them, within their own skin. You know what I mean? And have fun and not have to worry about a bunch of bullshit. You know what I mean? Could you imagine back in the day going to an arcade and someone starting a fight and all that type of shit? And you should know how that usually ended. But in these type of places, when you see these people and you have these people talk on camera and they're so friendly and they're very happy at what they do, and they're trying to spread that to everyone who comes in. There's kids walking, you know, children walking by in the window and they're pop locking in the window. You know what I mean? And interacting with the children that are walking by. It takes special individuals to do stuff like that. You know what I mean? Those people love what they do. And I don't think anyone can doubt that. But for some reason, like I said, you're seeing support of people who are being very negative in this video. You know, y'all ain't esports. We savage. Keeping it real. I can't believe that they're taking away our yelling and cursing each other out. And that gets supported. Places like this, where you can just go and have fun and not have to worry about shit, that doesn't get supported for some reason. Like I said, major overhaul for our mentality. The get good mentality. Meaning, get good. And I don't mean, you know, gameplay. Be good to others. Or as they would say, be awesome to each other. Is that what they say? Bill and Ted? Yeah. At this point, I think we really need it within all this negativity.